Okay, welcome back, everybody. This is a great Southern Billiard Tour stop here in Sanford, North Carolina at SpeakEazy Billiards. I'm Alvin Nelson with Inside Pool Magazine. I'm here with David King, a professional player from the area. How are you doing, David?
All right. How are you today, Alvin?
Good, man. We're getting through these rounds. We're getting this underway. We've got a good match here, Mike Fuller and BJ Ussery.
Yes, we do. Good to be back in the booth with you again.
You too.
Done quite a few matches this week.
Yep, you're doing good. Got our good friend Shannon Dalton running the event here. GreatSouthernBilliardTour.com. Make sure you check it out. Here at the finale.
And this match right here is on the one loss side.
Yep.
Mike Fuller, BJ Ussery, both North Carolina natives. Mike Fuller lives from Roxboro, North Carolina. BJ Ussery is from Greensboro, North Carolina. Both are well-established professionals.
I've never seen Mike Fuller play, but I did watch BJ play for the first time today.
You're in for a treat, Alvin. Mike Fuller is tournament tough. Quite possibly the best tournament player in North Carolina. BJ Ussery is as well.
So these guys have played quite a few times, I take it?
Yes, they have. They're quite familiar with each other's game. And we should be in for a nice treat here.
Who you like in this match?
I actually am going to have to flip a coin.
Really?
Honestly, I'm going to have to flip a coin.
Wow. That close.
I think if BJ is able to keep his temper under control, I would have to say he might have a slight edge in the match.
He gets a little excited, doesn't he?
Mike Fuller, you're not going to see much excitement out of him. You're not going to see any tantrums. He's going to get up and play his game.
I see.
And I really like Mike and BJ as well. I know Mike a little bit better. I've played him a couple times in a couple events. We're about right neck and neck with each other as far as matches won and lost.
I'll have to check out his game a little bit before I can. But just from what you're telling me, sounds like a good, solid player. Well, is he going to get fortunate? No.
So there's some trouble in this rack, Alvin.
Yes, there is. 7-8 for one
seven,
thing.
7-8.
4.
4 to the 5.
Yeah.
With the 7-8 being there, it almost takes away going back and forth across the table. Has to be hit very precise. We also have some good action going on in the room right now. Ryan Stone from Dayton, Ohio is actually playing Sam Monday, some one pocket.
I guess they're probably playing for more than the rent.
Just slightly. Now here's what you do on this shot. If you can't go back and forth across the table, you load it up with inside and come three rails around. Now if he can go back and forth, there's that three rail shot I spoke of.
Good shot, unless he scratches here.
Well, he's not going to scratch.
Barely. Played a good shot there. He has his earplugs in, so he can't hear us.
Right. BJ always plays with his earplugs in. He wants to keep 100% complete focus.
See that
and
little...
That there is...
He jammed that ball.
He's actually lucky that ball fell.
He did. I think he hit it with a little too much mustard.
You know, the adrenaline's going this late in the tournament. One lost side.
No, he ain't going to be able to make it playing shots like that. No, he gave him the game there. Well, yeah. The 7. Maybe he's making him deal with it.
Well, let's just put it in your shoes right here, Alvin. How would you like shooting the 7 ball from where the cue ball lies right there?
I'd go for the bank, but I'm from Ohio, so.
Can't really go for the bank there. You go for the 3 rail safety, parking the cue ball behind the 8. And honestly, that's what I think Mike Fuller is going to do right here. I don't think you shoot at this ball. I think you shoot and stop. Draw the cue ball just a little bit and put him right on the back of the eight ball with a nice.
Yeah, because even if he makes the seven, he's going to have to set up for a bank anyway. So,
I mean, he can go across table, but with these pockets, I think he's going to shoot at it. Wow, what a great shot by Mike Fuller.
Nice shot.
Like I said, this man
played that like
Earl. Now he is dead straight in the eight ball. He's going to have to just basically shoot and stop here and take the position that the table gives him. Just like that. And now you just roll the nine in.
That's the ideal. But I'll tell you what, this is not the easiest shot in the world.
Not at all. You're shooting into four-inch pockets.
Yeah. You're up on the treetops on the cue ball. Nicely hit ball, and he dogged it.
And we have a new rule in this tournament. There is no concession of the nine ball.
Yeah.
You will not be penalized for it.
No,
we have asked the players to shoot all balls.
Yeah, if they don't mind. If they don't mind. Which they have not. They've been doing real good. The only person that really screwed it up was BJ here. But you can't blame him. That was the first shot of the day, first match of the day. So.
I believe Vernon did it last night as well.
Yeah. Well, it's time to sharpen the saw here. And
I'll tell you what, though. Be prepared to see an all-out grind, because Mike Fuller will not give up by no means.
I don't think anything dropped.
And BJ has broke dry there, which is unusual for him. He has a pretty nice break. Mike's come a little bit far on this ball. There is some trouble on this rack as well. He can pocket the two ball. That's not really the problem. The problem
the four
is
ball.
The 4-9.
He's going to clip it, no?
Now's where you have to manipulate a shot.
Well, what he wants to do is go up there and touch the 9 and bump it out of the way and use the 9 to stop it. Watch him. He's going to run into the 9 ball here on purpose. No.
And that's uncharacteristic like of Mike Fuller. I think he was expecting the table to bounce out a little bit shorter, a little bit faster. And now he's stuck with
he's stuck.
Call a sellout kick.
Yeah.
There's really almost no way of kicking safe here.
No, there's nothing you can do.
The four ball doesn't go past the 9, so he can't.
Right, the 9's going to just stop it.
So he's just going to roll it. You know what?
That's
a great shot.
That's
all he could really hope for.
It's a good shot.
Now, BJ has a couple options here. Yeah, there's no bank on. He's going to put the four ball on the other side of the table.
Nice shot.
Wow.
But he's hooked.
He was not playing that shot.
No.
He was actually playing to put the four ball.
All right.
Let it go underneath the 7. And if it does that, it has a chance to come back around and go above the 9. And Mike would have been in a lot of trouble. Now he's forced to kick at this ball. What a great
shot
that is.
Good hit. He's got a makeable ball here, but I think he's probably just going to trade positions.
Just going to put him behind the 6 ball.
Good shot.
I mean, that's really a simple safe, you know. That's not anything that requires too much movement. And the less you travel that on these big tables like this, that, especially these big, tight, fast tables,
for sure,
the better off you're going to be. BJ's just going to try to clip this ball and put him behind the eight ball. He actually kicked at it. I don't like that shot there. He was able to see the left side of the four ball. I like just sort of thinning it and trying to put the cue ball behind the eight. I believe Mike Fuller will clear this up with no problem.
Yeah, you better hit these balls pure because these pockets will rattle on you.
Yes, they will.
This guy seems like he hits balls real good, hits them real pure.
Very solid player. Has his own unique style of play. He's known all throughout the Carolinas and the southeastern states as being a super tough, grinding player, especially this late in the tournament.
Nice shot.
He's falling a little bit short. Now he's going to have to play below the nine ball here.
Yep.
You draw it over the rail, try to kill it. Not the easiest of shots.
I don't like that.
I don't either. That's.
He threw his cue up in the air too. Did you see that?
Yeah, that's not.
Well, he kind of got fortunate though, because he left BJ a really tough hit cut. Not really tough, but.
I have to make sure I thank Mike later for making me sound like I don't know anything up here.
I like using an open bridge on this shot, but BJ's a better player than me. Yeah, see. See, he had a chance right there. He had a total chance. Wow, he got lucky.
He stuck him.
He got lucky.
Right on the back of the nine ball. And Mike's taking a good look at it. And, one thing you will not see out of Mike is a lot of emotion. Hit.
He hit it nice, yeah. They left him a lot of green in the yard.
BJ has to feel very fortunate to be back at the table.
For sure.
This is uncharacteristic like of both of these players.
I don't like hitting bottom on that shot. I like rolling that ball forward. It's too easy to jam it when you put draw on the ball on that shot.
A little ticky safe there. Make sure he doesn't scratch. And he is looking at it. Very nice shot by Mike Fuller.
Yeah.
Now that table right there, I'm just going to let you know this out there, your viewers that haven't tuned in to some of the previous matches, it has just a slight imperfection in it, as all tables do in their own way.
Bad safety.
And it rolls to that side there a little bit.
Yeah, it's got some leveling issues going on.
You know, if you recall the one pocket match that I played Friday night.
Yeah, everything was rolling off.
That my opponent lagged the ball, and it was rolling straight towards that the second diamond on the in rail, and rolled all the way in the corner pocket and scratched.
Yeah, that needs re-leveled for sure. But look at this! Wow, got lucky again.
And you notice the expression that on Mike's face.
Yeah.
Just taking care of business.
He's got a little clover leaf behind his ear. Getting lucky like that.
Well, just like that, after a rough game one, or I'm sorry, game two, our score is going to be one game each.
1-1.
And just take this time out to thank everybody out there for joining us for this. Glad to have all our viewers with us.
Yep, we got the nice crowd out there.
Like you said before, hope everybody's behaving on the chat.
Yep, they better be behaving. Well, Sally and JR are watching over the chat now, which is a job in its own sometimes. But everybody has fun out there. They just have a little too much fun.
Yeah,
sometimes.
I've seen a couple of things come across the chat that are...
they have a little too much fun sometimes. Hey, we love them.
That's a nice break there by Mike Fuller. Look at this.
Wow, hand shape on the one.
I'm going to tell you what, I played with him in Rocky Mount last weekend. And we were playing on diamond tables. Diamond smart tables, I should say. 9-foot tables. He was breaking the balls. And that's so hard. It was scary hard. It was almost Larry Neville-ish hard.
Oh, really? Larry the Tooth?
Well, Larry the Tooth, a.k.a. Truth. Or as Shannon Dalton like to call him, Mater.
Mater?
Mater.
Why? Because he gets red?
He gets...
His head gets red?
Oh, he gets as red as a bottle of ketchup. I mean, that's all there
yeah,
is.
Yeah, he looks like a fireball. One of them... Yeah, I swear he was a cherry tomato out there a couple times. Yep, Larry the Tooth. See, they're just not hitting them right, man. They're just not hitting those long shots right.
I think the nerves are kicking in, and that's, like I said, it's late in the day. Nice shot from BJ there.
Wonder what BJ's name is.
BJ's name is Billy Ussery. Billy Jr. Billy Ussery Jr.
Oh. Billy.
So instead of being called Billy Jr., uh-huh. This goes by BJ. That's what everybody in the whole pool world knows him as.
Uh-huh. Seems like a nice guy. It's my first tournament working with him.
So with that, our score is 2-1 in favor of BJ Ussery.
We're going to run a little commercial. Okay, we're back then. We'll watch Mr. Ussery break here.
Watch the wing ball.
Yep, the 8-ball is going to drop in the pocket. Nope.
Oh, he's
hitting them too hard, man.
I'll tell you what, in his match against Sam Monday, back on table number 7, Sam told me he was making 2 or 3 balls every break.
They're not working on this table. That break is not working.
The table's a little dry.
Mm-hmm. The lights.
Heated up. As we know how it can do.
Mm-hmm. There's some horsepower watts going on that table, so these guys can wear t-shirts. It's hot under there.
What a nice shot that was. Mm-hmm.
Missed every single ball on the table.
That's amazing with all that traffic down there.
It looked like a Samuel Sanger shot. You ever see his trick shot videos?
Sanger? Oh yeah, he's
dude's amazing, amazing, man. Yeah, there's no pool trick shot guy like him.
Ooh, what he can do with a ball is unreal.
Yeah, I don't care who any of those names that are on ESPN or anything. No, none of those guys can hang with that dude.
Get a chance, check out some of Sammy's stuff all over YouTube.
Yeah.
Or what they call an artistic pool player.
Yeah, he plays some amazing shots.
He's strictly a billiards player. No pockets. I'm sure he could probably pocket ball as well, too.
I'm sure he could play some. I'm sure he could play some pool.
If you check Semi Sagan around, you will be in for a nice treat.
Yeah, he's got a pretty amazing, like, an 8-minute video on there. It's like, wow.
Yeah, that's what you'll be doing the whole time.
Dude's incredible.
Wow.
Yep. I am not a big fan of trick shots, but I do like that guy's work. My game now is 10 ball. That's what I like.
I'm becoming a big fan of the 10 ball game. Slash bank pool.
See, I fall asleep at one pockets, man. Watching it. I really fall asleep. I don't know why.
Well, I really like to try to outthink my opponent.
It's a great game.
It's just so hard to outthink your opponent in an eyeball game.
Yeah, it's not.
Everybody runs out these days.
Yeah, we filmed a match with Nick Varner playing Alan Hopkins in the Patriot Cup in 2003. We did a video on that. One pocket. And
I
mean, it was...
I bet that took about 6 days.
I'll tell you what, man. I was asleep at the camera. I literally was sleeping.
Well, if I remember correctly, you were asleep in Goldsboro during a match.
I was asleep last night in a match, too, wasn't I?
Yeah. Actually, you were... You were sleeping at the wheel.
I was up on 30 feet in the air with the camera during the first UPA event in Virginia a long time ago. And I
remember that, man. I was there.
You were there?
Yes, I was.
Yeah, we had our whole film
Dragon
crew there.
Promotions.
Yeah, we had the big light over the table. You remember that big, huge light we had? It was like halide lights. And I actually fell asleep. We were watching Neil Sphan gamble all night. And I went in the next day. I was asleep at the camera 30 feet in the air. What happened there?
Now, there's been a concession of the nine ball.
That's fine. He can do it. Just let him do it. They've been told to please play the nine ball. There's a lot of new people watching.
Right. You know, a lot of them won't understand what's going on.
We've got quite a crowd watching right now, so. It can really mean the matter of a match, I mean.
And our score in this match is actually Mike Fuller 2, BJ Ussery 2. Shot there by BJ. He's going to fall absolutely perfect on the three ball.
Oh, he's in the trees now.
That's but not where you want to be on this particular table.
Pretty easy, easy ball to pocket here.
You're going to have to put him on the back of the six ball here. That's really the only shot. I don't like shooting the combo.
We'll take a look at the other angle. Well, it's there.
It's but there, it's but not the bank good is enough. There also, but I think
and he's got a cut in the side with the five ball. I think that's what he's looking at. I don't like that either.
Right. Just like that.
Yeah, that's well, he may have there. Not.
I believe he has his man can see half of the ball, but sometimes half of the ball is enough to make it or play a safe right back.
Well, he must have played his safety wrong because Mike just popped that ball in the hole.
Come down two rails. Just like that, nice shot. Now I think you can either draw this ball or you can just bounce down one rail, which I like the one rail angle, the backup table.
Nope, he hit the nine, but he may make it here, no.
Now here's an interesting situation here. You're gonna pocket this eight ball in the corner pocket, obviously. He's looking at the nine, because this is a two-way shot. If you miss the eight, then the nine can still go. Make the eight, you can still make the nine. But the key is, if you make the eight and don't make the nine, you want to make sure you hold position in order to cut that nine ball in the side pocket. You don't want to have any reason to shoot this nine in the corner as close as it is to the side pocket.
Now that's the right
speed.
See this
right here?
Beauty. Ooh, look at this. He screwed up.
He is actually going to be fine. He'll be able to just thin this ball in. He's taking a good look.
I don't know.
But that was the two-way shot that was there.
Yeah. I don't know about this one here, buddy. I think he's going to have to go to the end rail and come back, try to pocket it. I think he's going to kick at it. He's got to. He's got to kick at it.
If he does, he's really...
Superman,
a bad
huh?
roll if he has to kick at this ball.
He's going to have to make a Superman kick here.
I think you load it up with the outside.
He looks like he can make
cut
it.
This ball in the hole.
What? I don't like that shot.
Well, he went for a two-way. He really had his work cut out for him there. He banked it to the short side to try to leave it in the center of the table if he missed it. BJ has a tough shot, but a very makeable shot.
Nice shot
just
there,
like
BJ.
That there. It's going to be a 3-2 in favor of BJ Ussery. Yep. I'll tell you what, both these players are playing a little bit tender, aren't they?
Well, they're nervous, and it's been a long day, like you said.
I'll tell you, Mike Fuller is used to the spotlight
yep.
on Ustream. He's been on there several times. So mm-hmm. he's used to the spotlight, but not with near as many viewers.
Right. No, I don't like breaking from the box here. Made the wing ball. Maybe I stand corrected for today. Well, BJ knows what he's doing, so. Puts a lot of flash onto his stroke.
He's got a lot of move.
A lot of flair on his cue there.
I'll tell you what, if Nick Varner were to walk in this room right now, and he would feel like he has just received a Christmas present.
Oh, really?
And that if you happen to glance over at table number two, and look at the wedge of balls that mm-hmm. is in the top left-hand corner pocket.
He would love that for sure.
Speaking of a one-pocket match that's going on right now between Sam Monday and Ryan Stone.
They're at 1-1 right now. Right? 1-1 is their score. I see.
They're actually still in their first game. They're not playing where you mark them up if anybody out there knows what
I see. Yeah.
Brian White back here behind me.
Ready to jabber? All right, you sit here.
I'm going to have Brian White come in with me for a
I'm
going to
step out for a while since I've been here all day. I'm going to let Dave take over because he's the man.
Good. What's going on?
Tough tournament so far. Through day one, through the winter. Yeah, tough matches earlier today.
This is a tough little field.
Yeah, yes, it was. Pretty good size field compared to what we've had in recent weeks. Seems to be playing about as good as ever.
I'm trying. It's still making the occasional mistake. I'm trying to whittle those out.
No, I'm sure they're just fine. I noticed you had your rematch with Alex Oldinger from Carolina Open.
Oh, I know. We played each other, that's the third or fourth time now in just a few tournaments.
Yeah, actually played each other twice at the Open. The person to defeat him in that tournament.
I think BJ plays more consistent. I've been watching Mike play this weekend, and I've seen him make a lot of mistakes. I'm not sure if that's typical for him, but I think BJ is more solid. No, of course that doesn't mean that he can't win a race to 11, but if I was a betting man, I'd have to bet on BJ in this match probably.
Up on the five.
these rails play a little bit lively. I find that I've played actually three or four matches on this table. I find that I try to stay in open areas more, because when you start getting into that really technical position, and if you have to use the rails, it gets a little tricky. These rails on this particular table are a little bit lively.
Well, they were quite live last night. I played Chris Palmer on this table, and both of us scored quite a bit. Nice shot that was.
Right after I said Mike's been making a lot of mistakes, he'll probably play perfect.
Just shoot his way out of them sometimes. I mean, he did that quite a bit in Rocky Mount last weekend. Looks like he's going to be absolutely perfect on this ball here. Just bounce up.
I can't tell. I guess he's got an angle.
He can either come out two rails or just pop up. I like the two rail angles times his pockets are, just like that.
Yeah, it's an angle on.
Draw back a little bit, play the nine inside.
Tell you something else I noticed, that these side pockets play a little funny. If you hit them with any kind of speed on this table, they can hit the one side, hit the other, and spit back out.
I've noticed that in a couple of matches that I've been in the booth on. And I just thought it's going to be three games each.
Mike actually had him 5-1, and then three consecutive games he missed a 7, 8, or 9 straight in.
I noticed that.
And then he ended up losing the match.
I actually, my first match of the day today, had Tony 7-4, both of us going to 9. And had a little mental error. Come back to where it was 8-8. Broke, made a ball. Fell a little bit long on the 9 ball, down to all the Indian rail, had a super tough cut on the side. I actually did what you were speaking of on this table, caught the point, and it bobbled out. Tony had a fairly tough shot on the 9 to complete the match, and missed it in the corner, and it went 2 rails on the side.
Oh, okay.
He had to basically say thank me for shopping at Walmart.
Looks like both these guys have gotten the corner ball wired now. This table's broke tough for me all week until that last match with Alex. It broke a little better in the last match.
Notice we've got some on-pocket action going on. Stone is playing Sam Monday.
Yeah, I don't know how they stand, but I think they're playing 50 a game.
Yeah, it's the first game. It's real close and ball count. Playing sort of a Nick Varner type wedge game in there, it seems like.
Oh, it is the first game?
It is still the first game. It's been going on for about 45 minutes now. Shot here. Now, if the one ball is frozen, it's not quite as tough.
think he's so straight in that he cannot go forward. I think he has to jack up and shoot it, which makes it obviously tougher.
Oh, absolutely. Now BJ doesn't have the easiest of shots here either. Sort of over the side pocket a little bit. He's got to bounce.
Which that can,
rails.
Yeah, that can hurt a little bit, or it can help. I mean, if the rubber behind the side pocket's interfering, it can hurt a little bit. But I like to have that open area as opposed to shooting flush off the rail.
Oh, absolutely. This full crown here is not a pockets aren't shaved now. Went on the other side of the rail.
The match on the other table is 7-6, Alex. The other guy's going to 7, and Alex is going to 9, so the other guy's on the hill. I played that guy earlier. He's a good B player.
Vernon?
Yes.
Vernon Rogers.
Shot right here that I've had a little trouble with on this table this week about slow rolling the ball forward, like a shot that's almost straight in. I've had trouble with on these, something about this table or this ball. I've just had trouble pocketing the ball like that.
That's a good shot. Nice shot there.
Yeah.
After Aaron.
Guess who's back? Alvy's back with Davey too. What up, Davey?
Not a whole lot.
You're King David.
I had to chat a little bit with Thumper Brian White for a few moments.
Yep, you're King David. David King.
Do what I can and enjoy every minute.
Man,
of
you
it.
Can't ask for a better last name than King. That's a pretty good last name.
I should have a great shirt over in my room. From Nike. It says right on it, it's good to be king.
Nice. Now, are you related to Stephen King?
I wish I was. I'd have a much better stake horse.
All right, so what's our score here? Since I just stepped back in.
Our score is 4-3 right now.
In flavor of Mr.
I'm going to say it's I believe it is BJ.
I thought I saw him win the last game there. Looks like he's hooked on the eight ball.
No, he's actually he's straight in here. Actually put his extension on his cue. He's not gonna be happy with that. He is straight in. He's gonna take a nice shot though to come over to the side rail. That's a nice stroke there from PJ. Have to shoot and stop here for the six ball in the opposite corner pocket. Oh, he jumped right up in the air on that shot.
Sure did.
It's very uncharacteristic like.
What's going on? He's getting upset. Okay.
Back with you now. I had to make a few adjustments there.
Yeah, we are. I mean, these live streams, you get it all, man. I mean, you get the raw feeling of the room. You really do. The players. I mean, we are right there.
Right there. We're excessively close to the table.
But.
Oh wow. Falling just a little bit short on this ball. This is becoming a, I don't know how I really want to say it, they're both not pocketing balls very well.
There's a lot of pressure, man. You got the cameras, you got two guys talking about your game 5 feet away.
Well, not to mention,
the lights.
Winner of this, go to play the loser of the King of the Hill match.
And this is the one lost side. This guy's getting mad, isn't he?
We spoke of that temper earlier.
It's been the downfall of a lot of great players.
Yes, it has. And that first game of one pocket, and that has taken almost an hour over there. Sam Monday has actually won the first game. Did a nice straight back bank, and our score is six games to four.
Favor of BJ?
Favor of BJ Ussery.
Well, what's he all upset about? Six to four.
I'm Not exactly sure what the problem is.
Oh, I'm sure somebody would gladly take his place on the TV table if he'd like to move his match. You know? Should feel lucky that he's on there. I mean, not really, but... I'm sure you'd like to be playing there, Dave, right now.
I would love a dose of it.
But then all the people on Ustream would have to just listen to me talk, and that's not fun. We'd just get JR in here with his expert commentary. I can't hang with JR on the commentary, man.
Yeah, I can't quite get up there yet.
He's good.
I'm working my way up on it, that's for sure.
He played some amazing, he called some amazing shots yesterday, man, where exactly what he said happened. It's pretty amazing.
And I'm going to tell you this, it looks like Vernon Rogers has defeated Alex Oleguer.
Alex was talking about his break being super good.
Mike hit this ball a little bit firm.
Sure did. We want you all to go to the GreatSouthernBilliardTour.com. Follow what Marge and Shannon are doing out there, their tour next year.
It's going to be great.
And we want you to buy their T-shirt, which is designed by Mike Basha, and it's on the site.
I'll tell you what, he did some great work with the designing of the logos for the T-shirt.
Yeah, we got to give him props. But definitely go on the GreatSouthernBilliardTour.com and get a T-shirt. And send Marge and Shannon nice messages on Facebook and stuff. Add them.
They are out there on Facebook as well.
Doing a great job. They gave us an awesome Christmas dinner.
Oh, that was fantastic.
Was that yesterday morning?
That was yesterday.
I can't
early
remember
afternoon.
What day it is.
39 pounds of turkey.
Shannon was out there in his camo boots and camo shirt at 8 o'clock
snow.
In the morning. Yep, out there cooking, sitting on his chair with the cooker. Cooking.
Tell you what, deep fried turkey is a southern thing.
Yeah.
And
interesting.
Tell you what, I don't know how to explain it, but it was phenomenal.
We had a great dinner, and they did that for the entire field of players. So 60 people
field.
Ate.
Not to mention the people that came in that
just strolled
were,
in the door.
You know, pool junkies, as you might call them, that were also invited to this event that don't play.
And we also want you to visit InsidePoolMag.com and also InsidePool.tv. And we want you to go to PoolPlayerExcuses.com, too, to check out the towel. And TheCutShot.com, one of our other sponsors. So that's about it. So back to the match.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of cut shots,
there we go.
It's like Mike Fuller's going to have a nice little cut on the one ball on the side.
A segue.
Had a nice break there. Pocketed two balls.
He's got a good break. Another amazing adventure down here, I tell you. And I want to thank everybody out on the Ustream supporting us.
Couldn't do it without you.
Guys, post all these links to your Facebook. Let everybody know the finals are coming up pretty soon, so that should be awesome. Shannon Dalton said he's going to be doing commentary.
And I'm going to predict the finals right now. This is just a prediction, but I would say it's going to be most definitely Brian White.
Mike Fuller.
And Mike Fuller.
He can stay. I can tell this guy stays smooth. He's not mad.
But I can say one other thing. Don't count out Tony Morrison. I think after that nice little beat he put on me, Hill, or shot, I should say, he went and won his match after that against Mike Fuller, who's playing right now. And he will play Brian White for the hot seat that coming up after this. Okay. And there's 5-6 in favor of BJ Ussery.
Enjoyed commentating with you, Dave.
It has been great. It's been a great year. Now, if you notice something right there, I didn't like that. BJ Ussery just touched the one ball with his hand.
He's been doing that the whole time.
I do not like that at all. I had Shannon in stopping players from doing that at a tournament in Inman, South Carolina.
A lot of the guys do that.
You need, if you're going to touch the balls, you need to do it with the rack on the balls.
What's the benefit, you think, there? The unfair advantage?
I don't want to say the word cheating. I'm not using that, so don't anybody out there on that stream take me the wrong way.
Seems like they're just trying to freeze the one ball.
Well, what can happen a lot of times, accidentally, is that when someone touches the one ball... Notice how the wing ball shot in right there?
Nice.
Okay, now, back to what I was saying. When someone touches the one ball, it loosens up the wing ball and squeezes it out a little bit. And if it's not going from a certain position where they're breaking from, it wires it to that corner pocket.
I see.
That's why I don't like players touching at the rack without the rack on the ball.
Well, there you see the result of it. More than likely. The old players, they didn't even look at the rack. They let the other player rack. They didn't look at it.
Right.
Buddy Hall, Strickland, all them guys. They didn't even care what was frozen or nothing. It didn't matter.
Yeah, we know who all brought the rack into play. And our good friend Corey Duell had a lot to do with the rack.
Yeah.
He was able to learn more about it than quite a few players. Where to hit it at when it looks like it's racked a certain way by another player.
Yep, very interesting individual, Mr.
Yes,
Corey Duell.
Very intelligent.
Yep.
I don't think there's no such thing as being able to slug rack Corey Duell.
Yeah, he knows how to hit the rack from anywhere.
I mean, people might not think this. He has a really good hard break as well.
He's a great player.
Actually, later on tonight, we might be able to get you an update from the Turning Stone event. See how that's going. I know Corey and Dennis Hatch. We're on the winner's side starting today. DJ stuck himself to the rail, but I don't think he'll have any trouble here.
No. If he doesn't start getting angry, he'll possibly do okay here.
That's a nice shot by BJ. Stayed down, and then followed through, and then made a nice stroke, rolled the ball in the hole. Our score is going to be 7-5 in favor of BJ Ussery.
Go ahead, Bob.
To all you viewers out there, if you'll notice, these players are starting to get a little more in focus, get a little more in gear.
just hit that way too hard.
That's misfortunate there for Mike. I didn't really see that coming.
Well, it's
easy to get carried away with that Predator BK, too. Cue ball explodes off the tip. Those of you out there looking for a great break cue, that get a hold of Neil, Jacksonville, Florida, Predator Products. He'll be sure to take care of you.
He's got the 7 or the 2 quite a ways in the pocket there, but I'm sure he's fine. Boy, that ball looked like it rolled there. It hit a piece of chalk or something.
It caught something now.
Did you see that too?
Yeah,
see it roll up?
It looked a little funny there.
Like when it stopped, it rolled towards
roll
the top of the
ball
screen.
Inside.
Yeah, he dogged it.
Wow.
Well, there obviously wasn't anything there. He would have brushed the table.
Yeah, if that would have been Johnny Archer, he would have went by and picked up stuff that wasn't even on the table there.
Earl talks about little pieces of chalk on the table.
It happens all the time. You
little,
can't help it from
boulders.
Happening.
Talking about hitting a boulder.
I hit this boulder.
I think he was in the doing pretty good in that tournament that's going on right now. Actually, I heard.
Yes.
I thought I heard he was in the winner's side. Old early bird.
Gabe Owen is as well. He actually put Johnny Archer to the one loss side.
Well, all our we're not up to date with it. We've been trapped in Great Southern Billiard Tour land. So
it's a great land to be in.
Yeah, it's fun. We're having a lot of fun here. I'd rather be here doing this actually.
Yeah, I've played on quite a few tours in my career. Including Mike Zuglin's Josh Northeast Tour. And I can honestly say this is one of the toughest events that you will play in, as far as being, if you're a higher ranked player, that you really have to come with it. And it really gives a lot of the amateurs that an advantage to come out and play with players that, you know, they would really like to play with and learn something from. And Mike Fuller is starting to take charge a little bit. The score is now 7-6 in favor of BJ Ussery. Still a very close match.
Watch him touch the ball again. We'll see if he's going to touch the ball.
Now, if Shannon Dalton, our tournament director, sees this, he will go say something.
Yeah, he didn't touch it.
He's satisfied with the rack?
Well, I guess if it freezes up, right, if those four balls freeze, you know. Ball is almost guaranteed as long as you don't crush it. These guys are hitting it way too hard. Now he's breaking from the rail. I think he's figuring out that this table's not liking break from the box. And he's still a little bit off, though. I don't like that. See, he missed. He didn't make anything, did he?
Did you notice how the rack wasn't touched? But also, this is a rack-around format. 9 ball. ball does not count in the bottom two corner pockets. A lot of times if you leave the back three balls loose in a rack, the nine ball can shoot to one of the right or left hand corner pocket, and it will spot up if it goes in those pockets.
For sure.
Immediately after the break, it will count as a ball pocketed.
Right. I saw it go in on the top yesterday.
Here's a push out from Mike Fuller. Also, the proprietor of this pool room does not allow jump cues. So you can jump with your full cue, playing cue, not your break cue.
Hit that.
It hurts. Came out.
I heard something go wrong there.
I believe his cue, the forearm of his cue touched the table.
That's what it was.
I'll tell you what, that was a great shot he came up with.
It worked. Yep.
2-9 caroms wired. Whether he likes to shoot it or not is another story, but I believe it's on.
Well, he sure is looking at it, isn't he? I just like running out here.
Well, he doesn't really have a pocket for the two ball, I don't believe. If it goes past the nine, then yes, you go ahead and you run out here.
I guess it goes.
He's looking in shape on the three ball. I know he would like to come back down a little farther. Two rails.
You know, I can't see the chat, but I'm really psychic, okay? And I can feel that they're going off over there. They're having way too much fun.
They probably are.
Because JR's back in the room, and he can't see what's going on, so I think they're taking full advantage that I can't see them and you can't see them.
Yeah,
I got a bad feeling about those guys in the chat right now. I think they're going crazy.
Wow, what a stroke there.
Guys better behave.
That was not an easy shot by Novi.
That was sweet shot, man.
He hit that ball. 200 and change.
That was some traveling. He was doing some traveling there.
But hit it with excessive control. As well as excessive speed.
He's been doing some traveling.
Well, he knows this is a close match.
He travels
right back into this.
Yeah. He took that thing so far that, you know, he's where the streets have no names.
Nice, falling out a lot of shots here, but he's shooting his way back into it. Draw the side row back out. Don't want to hit the eight.
Nice shot.
Now, I don't think for a minute that he thought that ball was going to get anywhere near that side pocket.
No, he took too much mustard on it, trying to do too little one, too flashy, you know. He's jumping up now. He needs to relax.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure. I like rolling that ball a little more, because even if you get straight in on the eight ball, shoot and stop or roll the eight in, and positions have been automatic.
This is the pocket, too. This is the bad pocket. This is the rattler. He's got to hit this pure as the driven snow, buddy. Let's see. He hit too much of it. He left BJ out.
like to have a mic on, that's for sure. Playing this in.
BJ's commentating that he like to have a mic on. These guys are having fun, you know, as much as they can. I think the talking gets him in his groove, you know. I think he's like Earl. He's real similar to Earl, not his game-wise.
Well, they're from the same city in North Carolina.
Oh, really?
Greensboro.
Well, there you go.
And our score is going to be 8-6 in favor of BJ Ussery.
I can just tell just by seeing these guys so much who you know, influences are. Yeah, he definitely was Earl-esque there when he was talking to us there a minute or two ago. He had that look in his eye, that blank stare. That Earl Strickland look.
Well, I will say this much. BJ voices his opinion on things.
I like that,
though. Quite well.
I like that. It makes for an interesting game.
Maybe at the wrong time, but...
You know, that's this kind of... He's like Mike Siegel and Earl. They just talk.
I don't know if there's anybody as good as Mike Siegel at talking.
Yeah, he's... Well, his nickname's Mike the Mouth. And if you want to go to his new website, it's MikeSiegelBilliards.com. Which is a great new website. Support Mike Siegel, because he's just, you know, he's trying to stay modern, and he wants to do it, and he's got the vision, you know. So
check it out.
Yeah, JR built the site. So.
And there's another unforced there. From Mike Fuller. BJ's going to start to smell blood here if he's able to close this rack.
It's three games from winning it, so. We want to thank D&DQ Repair for some nice pens they gave us.
Oh, absolutely.
So, guy's a nice guy. Talking to him.
Dave Buchholz actually did some great work for me. Appreciate him very much. I will never have any tip work done by anybody else except him.
Yeah, he seems like a nice guy. So he left us a bunch of pens up here to use, which is really nice because we always need pens. So, hey, you know, we like to thank everybody that helps us during these streams. That's what we're here for, you, you know, everybody. Come down and hang out with us. And
I would have been... dead in the water if he hadn't fixed my cue for me. I actually split my ferrule in two spots.
Oh, he's here working, so.
He said that this one's on me.
Nice.
New ferrule, new tip.
Comes down here to make money and gives you a free repair.
I did sort of help him get in here a little bit. I put the little, the bird in Jimmy Bullis's ear about him wanting to come do the tip work, and they worked out something to where it profited both of them, and
it's good. Well, we want you to also check out our online yearly subscription to Inside Pool Magazine. It's an electronic version of the magazine, and it's a real low price for a whole year, and you get videos inside the magazine and other things that the magazine doesn't have. So check out that electronic subscription on InsidePoolMag.com, please. Keep supporting us to keep doing these streams, because we love to do it, and we love to bring you this pool while you're stuck in a snowy place with all wrapped up in a blanket next to a heater. You can watch the pool with Dave and I, with JR.
It's our absolute pleasure to bring it to you.
Yep, you'll be at Derby City.
Yes, I will.
As will I and JR, and we'll be bringing you videos. Not sure what kind of videos yet, but.
I don't plan on sleeping a whole lot during those 9 days.
It's a pretty wild tournament. It really is one of my favorite tournaments of the year.
90% of the pool world will be there, whether you're a league player, average gambler.
The only bigger
tournament player, you'll all be there.
Yeah, the only bigger thing is Super Billiards.
And you know, I have never been to that.
That has the most pool players going to it that I've seen. But I know there's another one in Vegas that's like the amateur championships and stuff like that. There's just like a trillion people there. Well, just think of how many pool tables there are in the world. Do you think there's any other sport that has more besides like checkers or chess?
No. There's no way.
There's way more. There's pool tables everywhere.
And they're going to take
a little second break here, huh?
2-minute break, so.
Well, let's run a little commercial here, okay? Sounds good.
Be right back.
See you in a second.
Here's some breaking news. Inside Pool Magazine can now bring the world's greatest players right to your front door. Subscribe to Inside Pool for the annual price of just $19.99. Each issue is action-packed with high-impact photos, tournament coverage, in-depth player profiles, and much, much more. Call 888-428-7665. That's 888-428-POOL. Here's some breaking news. Inside Pool Magazine can now...
Dave.
All right, back with you.
David King here with me. I'm Alvin Nelson from Inside Pool Magazine. And we're happy to be here with you, everybody. Got quite a few people on
pleasure.
The Ustream. So glad you're here. Listening to the Zen of David and I talk about a bunch of nothing.
About any and everything, it seems.
Any and everything. We're at story time.
Just
over
a little
here.
Bit.
Sometimes it's story time. So get out your milk and cookies.
Maybe take a few notes if you'd like.
Yeah, it's milk and cookie time. Dave and I got a plate of cookies and milk, and we're up here watching this game up close to the table. Mom just made them fresh out of the oven.
They make gold milk?
I had camel milk in Dubai in my coffee.
That?
I just put it in my coffee. You think I'd really drink it?
I was kind of hoping not.
They had some amazing food in United
Arab
Emirates.
Let's see what BJ Ussery can do with this break here.
Okay. Yeah. Looks like he's good.
Wing nut shot dead end.
Yep. Did he touch the ball? Did you see him touching the
yes,
one ball?
He did.
He touched the one ball after the rack was off. You were watching it, weren't you, Dave?
I don't like that.
You were watching it, buddy.
Him, I just don't like that. I don't think if...
Davey doesn't like it, guys.
I don't think if all the other players are allowed to do it, I don't think he should be allowed to.
All right, so our score now... 8-6. I'm going to check that out for you real quick. That ball real nice.
Very nice shot there. Yeah, Mike Fuller won that last game. Our score is 8-7. Made that fantastic shot on the 9 ball.
We've got our statistician, Brian White. As well as being in the, is he in the finals?
He's getting ready to play Tony Morrison for King of the Hill.
Oh, King of the Hiller. Yeah, had a pretty amazing time in the United Arab Emirates, now that I mention it, at the World 8 Ball Championship. Pretty crazy event over there.
Oh, I can imagine.
It's about a 16-hour plane ride.
Into the wind, huh?
I was in the middle seat.
Oh.
It was brutal, man. I was about to smash my head against the wall at the end of the flight. But yeah, the food was great over there.
Oh, BJ was very fortunate there. He
look at this.
Let the cue ball loose.
He almost.
That ball about went in the side pocket.
Sure did.
The score is 9-7. Favorite BJ Ussery.
Man, you might be eating your words here about who wins this match. Might be eating the old words.
I mean, I'm very, you know.
You'll admit it, won't you?
I very well might be.
You were wrong.
I knew who I liked going in.
Yeah. Well, they're talking. BJ's talking about how excited he is. He ran out. These guys are having a good time. They're getting smoother now, you know. It was tough at the beginning, you know, you're a little jittery.
When it always is.
When you realize you're stuck. You're stuck with us, you know.
Nice break there by Mike. Looks like he's going to come up with a shot.
Sure is. Got a little cutlery going on there.
So I'll tell you one thing about going to this table. Everybody wants to play in the spotlight. It's all fun and games until you get to the spotlight.
Until you get there, huh?
And when you make your opening shot underneath those bright lights and all these cameras, it changes things. Your whole mind at
it. I bet.
Whole train of thought.
Unlike anything, huh?
It's unlike anything else I've ever seen.
Yeah. Because you see the amount of people watching, so.
And a lot of times, you won't even see these people in your life who are watching you.
I don't know. There's a lot of people that you and I know on there
that
admit that they're watching.
You and I.
Yeah.
But let's say some of the local players, some of the local players that
were
on this table.
We definitely get a lot of hits from people that have no idea.
They're not going to see people that are reviewing this. I mean, they don't ever leave their town. No, unlike you and I, who travel all over the country, you all over the world.
Yep.
You probably know 90% of our viewers right now, or have met them at one point in time, or they've seen you work.
Yeah, I've been around for a while, but I'll tell you, Dave, doing these commentaries and stuff, you know, people are going to start to get to know you better, buddy. And you got a great game. I really like your game a lot, so I think you got a good future. No problem. I think you got a good future, man, so. You played exceptionally well against Chris Ballmer last night, I thought.
I really wish Chris would have played better.
You just outplayed him, man. It's real simple.
I saw the viewers out there and other people. When can we expect these videos to be uploaded for view?
They'll be on YouTube and next day or so.
Great.
So that would
be.
Any
of you out there that might have missed a match that you want to see, or a player that you want to see?
Evening of the 20th, I'd say. It's the 19th. A
couple days or so, and then you'll be able to check those out.
And JR will do all the uploading and when he gets back to town. I think he's working on doing that now too. So
meanwhile,
a pool match broke out.
BJ Ussery is going to go to the hill.
Hill time.
He's going to take a lead 10-7, and with the break. So that is extreme advantage for BJ Ussery.
All he has to do is not crush them.
There's no need to.
Just hit the side break. And there he goes, touching that one ball again.
And
beating on the table.
Sorry, I just do not like that.
Well, Mike Fuller has no problem with it, so. He don't care.
He does not care.
Well, I'm not going to say any names, but last summer at this event...
Oh, I know a top 10 player that does that.
Well, there was some conflict in the finals of this event last summer when I was here, and I don't think there needs to be any of that again. So I don't think Mike Fuller's going to say a word.
Nope, he wasn't even paying any attention. That's just the guy's game, you know? They obviously know each other.
Mike's dad plays pretty well. Peaches Fuller.
Peaches?
Peaches. Go ahead and say hi to Peaches. I actually played him in Rocky Mount. Wonderful gentleman.
I like to say hi.
One thing he did, he raised a great pool player.
Yeah, this guy can definitely tell he has his stuff together. I think he's going to get a foul here. No, he can get down to that bottom. That's good.
Yeah,
nope, I was right.
He's going to get the foul. That's for sure.
Yep.
That was a rough shot there.
Yeah, he's not happy.
Shannon Dalton behind us making reservations for a vacation.
Now, all you advertisers out there, I want you to realize the power of these videos in advertising. And we're very selective on who we advertise with. So I'd like you to go to thecutshot.com and poolplayerexcuses.com. Those are two of our sponsors. But you guys realize that this is it, man. Inside Pool TV, we get a lot of hits on our videos. Tremendous amount of hits, post show and during the show. So appreciate everybody out there supporting our stream by hanging out in the chat, being nice and good, being well-behaved pool fans that I know you're doing now that you know I can't see you. While we watch things disappear down holes, there's a whole nother world going on there in that chat room.
Yes,
I guarantee
is.
It. I can feel it, man. I can feel it. It's on fire, that chat board.
Man, I'm not sure everybody out there, all of our viewers are actually at right now, but in our time zone, it's 8 o'clock.
Oh, yeah.
Our finals will probably be brought to you
about 10-ish.
10:30 or 11 tonight.
Yeah. So if you got to get up and go to work tomorrow, you'll be able to see these on YouTube, which you're probably watching on YouTube right now in a couple days that it's already been a couple days. But yeah, they'll all be on YouTube.
They can always do like me. A lot of times I'll lay right in bed with my laptop right on my lap and fall asleep watching a great match. It's
Oh man.
A lot of times I just want to hear myself talk. So
there you go.
I want to see.
I can't stand it.
What I'm doing wrong and what I'm not.
I'm more
of a. I need to work on. So.
I was forced into being a commentator because nobody wants to do it. So I like doing my post-edited videos, which I also have a YouTube channel besides I work on Inside Pool, but it's World Alvin. Just search World Alvin on YouTube, and you'll find my YouTube channel. Please subscribe. And, you know, I've been doing a lot of videos for Inside Pool this year, so most of my stuff's on Inside Pool. But I do have some custom videos that I have, about 30 or so, so check it out. Anyway, here's Mr. Ussery locked up.
It's a little unique how this ball goes. Now,
I don't know. It turned out okay for him.
I'm surprised he didn't shoot the four square in the face. Pretty much good. The seven ball goes up table, stopping the cue ball right there. The four ball has no choice but to go in the side. And it actually rolls in.
Yeah, he's in a difficult situation here.
Very difficult. I don't like
he's gonna spin backwards.
I don't like this. I like going two rails with this.
Yeah.
That's so difficult.
So they're at one foul apiece now for this rack, right?
As we hear some wonderful music in the background, Pink Floyd song would be called Marooned, I believe.
Yeah.
Great relaxing music.
Maybe this will meet, will smooth BJ out. Maybe he'll smooth him out for the win. You think? He's kind of an amp player. He's had a couple too many of them dang energy drinks that you like so much. You drink those puppies for breakfast, don't you?
Oh, I wake up with one.
Man, that's crazy. That taurine stuff, man. Made by them Germans. Germans invented that stuff. You got to watch out for them Germans. Oh, wait, I'm German.
Yeah, my mother doesn't like it when I drink them. My son actually wants to start drinking.
He did. I saw him drinking one at Michael's.
Yeah. Gotta leave it to Tara.
Yep, Tara. Let's give a shout out to Tara.
Hey, Tara.
What's up, Tara?
If you're checking us out tonight, I miss you, girl. Wish I could come back and see you.
Yeah, she wanted to be in the pictures on the Michael's. She was mad that she wasn't in the photo gallery, so we got to give her a little shout out.
I think I'm gonna stop by and see her possibly Tuesday afternoon sometime, Tuesday evening.
Michael's is a good room.
I'll be back in Cincinnati for a little while. I'm gonna stop by and see her, try to give me a little action maybe.
In the diamond mine.
Games there.
David and I are having too much fun here, people. It's a good tune.
It's a great tune, isn't it?
Yeah. We have no control over what music's playing here. This is a public establishment, so.
I have seen this tour live, 1994, very, very young.
Yeah, I remember that.
Mile
what are you,
stadium.
31?
I'm sorry?
31? You're 31?
31.
Yeah, I'm 34. Oh, at Mile High Stadium in Colorado there?
Denver, Colorado.
That's where that crazy Air Force airport is.
DIA.
That crazy, it's got the all the crazy stuff going on it.
It's insane.
Underground bases and aliens and all that. everybody knows I'm a conspiracy nut. Hell, I want to say hi to Max Eberle, my fellow conspiracy nut.
Hey, I know Max.
What up, Max? What up, brother? You out there? He's helped us out on these. He does great commentary.
Oh, I can imagine.
I can't wait to get him back, man. He's such a good host. Max is awesome. We went to Virginia State Nine Ball this year in Richmond. We'll see if BJ can get out here. Should have got up and walked around and reset and went to look at the angle from the other side of the table is the way to do it, I think.
He's actually left Mike a really tough shot.
Mm-hmm.
Mike is
considering
not,
Mike's about 5 foot tall.
Yeah, Mike is not a tall person at all.
But he's got to get the rake out now.
I'll tell you what, I'm 6 foot one and I have a hard
I'd
time
never be able to reach. Yeah, I'm not even 6 feet. I would never be able to reach. This. right. And he scratched. I just have to say that that's probably the end of the match there.
Yeah, I don't see BJ making a lot of mistakes from here. The fact that I called the match wrong.
Well, it's very easy to do with these caliber players, man.
Yes,
who's ever having a better day? And BJ's had the advantage of playing on this table earlier, and Mike has not.
Correct.
And he knows nothing about the table walking into this match. So, and BJ already knows about the table.
Looks like this is going to do it. Roll the 8 on the side, bounce out middle of the table. And I do not believe what I just
saw. I eat my words. Foot goes into mouth.
I mean... BJ's over acting like he wants to throw something. I don't blame him. I'd be mad at myself, too. I don't need to be mad at anybody else, though.
Yeah.
Let's see what Mike's able to do here. Wow. I don't think BJ can cut this ball in.
Two uncharacteristic misses.
Very uncharacteristic by this caliber of player. I'm actually at a loss for words right now. I don't know what to say to our viewers out there.
Wow. Oh, man, look at this craziness.
Shot at a flyer.
Look at that craziness.
I guess when you're up 10-7, going to 11, you can shoot at those shots.
That's a pretty crazy shot right there, buddy. Okay.
10-8.
Hey, you never know what's going to happen, buddy.
What happened with Sam Monday and Ryan Stone?
Unbelievable.
Earlier?
Unbelievable.
5-0, Ryan Stone led Sam.
10 games in a row.
It's actually 11 games in a row.
11 games in a row. And won the set.
Pocketed the 6 ball. Looks like he has a 1-5 combination.
That's great when you win a set, win a game, and then it's your break. That's great. You get to keep with the roll after being iced. Yeah, he got fortunate to be his break now.
He can manipulate this out here. Puts him right back in it.
Or he's going to miss and give BJ the run out.
Let's see, you just saw the first sign of frustration from Mike. And what really has to frustrate him even more is it's BJ's shot. He's over on his cell phone.
Yeah, that's brutal action right there. Clapton's genius guitar playing.
Layla. He has no easy task in front of him here. This
he definitely does not. The shape from the 2 to the 3 is tough. Or you can play like that, then it's easy. See if he's going to be rewarded. He was rewarded. The fortune favors the bold. And he just got bold there. Yeah, it was a great shot. We got people in the audience here saying, wow.
I'm not sure what it takes to shoot a shot like that.
Brutal.
A lot of brains or a lot of stupidity.
That's a brutal situation for Mr. Fuller over there. He's trying and tried as hard as he could, man. And I can see it in his eyes. He knows the priest has come in the room and everybody's surrounded as we watch the nine ball disappear.
Watch
down.
Watch this right here. Watch where this cue ball ends up.
Oh, he's got a back cut on the nine ball. Wow. Acting like.
Now you see this shot right here, Alvin?
Yeah.
This is the shot that
I banked this
had
ball
against Tony earlier.
I bank it right now.
And I missed it. And
you tried to bank it?
No, I tried to cut it.
Yeah, I go for the bank here. Nice.
Look at this here.
Scratch.
This whole thing right here is hilarious. It's terrible.
Seeing the temper.
Ask the play guy.
We're seeing the temper of BJ Ussery. He's actually starting to give us a little bit of grief now.
Very difficult job we have, Dave. I'll tell you, man. People think this is easy. This is a tough action doing these matches.
And our score is 10 games to 9 in favor of BJ Ussery.
Yeah, it's definitely not easy for the dude to do this. So people out there, you know, we travel hard, far, and deal with a lot of stuff to do these streams.
Shot on the one ball, three ball goes in. Position is gonna be a little difficult here. Seeing a lot of unnecessary emotion from BJ. He actually referred to this as hilarious and said, ask the quiet guy. Referring to Mike Fuller.
Yep. Mike don't care.
We don't need any self-implosions here.
Mike didn't even blink. He don't care. He knows how this guy is. He just talks to him. Keeps his game going, you know. Just his way of doing. I don't like how it sharks people, but.
Nice bank shot there.
Looks like he's hooked.
I think when you pose yourself in that manner, you betray your game.
Yeah, I don't like getting upset, but
yeah, it looks like this ball here is going to get
bad.
Straight in.
Not good. He might as well follow it right into the pocket. You know?
Thank you.
you do here, Alvin? You roll it in.
I play safe. I try to kick the five ball into the lower left-hand, bank it in the lower left-hand pocket. Try to get it to hide behind the nine or something.
You gotta give yourself a chance to win the game. Gotta roll it in.
Nah. Too close to the rail, and I don't know.
I believe he's hooked, Mike.
Take a look at the other angle here. Too low of a percentage of a shot that five ball was.
Mike can get out here. It'll be his break at 10-10.
Could be right after all. Never know here.
I hate to say I told you so, but I called a match earlier. Oh, actually, I'm sorry, last night.
Yep.
For a person who did three games. And we got there. And look here.
Maybe the calm, cool, and collected guy will triumph in the end. This guy does not get rattled.
No, he does not.
He is like the Iceman.
I don't like how he's geared up on this ball here.
Yep. I don't think this match is over, man.
I like just rolling that ball in. He could have gotten the same exact position.
High ball.
He was.
Nothing fancy. High English. Outside. High outside English. Lucky he's so close to the side pocket there.
And that's going to do it. BJ Ussery is going to win the match 11 games to 9. And I want to thank everybody out there for joining us. Sit up here. I'm David King.
Thanks a lot, Dave. Appreciate
pleasure,
it, buddy.
I'll
as always.
I'll be back with you here shortly.
Yep, we're going to get ready and do another match. And remember,
got to be as good a player as Brian White to play on this table.
Yeah, well, you did good, BJ. So, all right, thanks, everybody. Remember, insidepool.tv. Thanks.
Check us out.
One of these corners, it rolls off.
Yeah, but you got to be careful.
Yeah, I'm